Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, and to all the Sabbath keepers out there, I say Shabbat Shalom. This evening, I'm doing a very special lesson. This lesson is about Sunday and the Sabbath, the seventh day and the first day of the week. You all must understand that this is extremely important, and before it's all said and done, you're going to have to know about each. And the reason why I say that is because you're going to have to make a choice to stand for one or the other. Now, for many of you, that may seem easy. You'll just stick with what you know, but it's not going to be that simple. It's going to be about your salvation. It's going to be about persecution. It's going to be about what you believe. It's going to be about who you're going to stand for. So don't presume just because you're doing one now that you're going to stay with it. What I'm going to tell you about today is how we got to where we are in terms of keeping Sunday for the majority of those of you out there. One thing I do believe is that people should have an informed decision about everything in their lives. And the problem is, many don't want to go this route. They just want to go along as sheep with the majority, not wanting to know the truth about many things. And they believe that that will keep them safe being with the masses. But that's not necessarily true. We're going to get into this and hopefully educate at least one of you about something that you didn't know when it comes to Sunday keeping and the Sabbath. Understand also when it comes to the Father's word that we are going to be held accountable. Rejecting knowledge of truth does not absolve any of us for what we should know. His word is out there. It's been out there. And we are all accountable for knowing it or not knowing it. Either or, we are fully accountable. Here's the difference. If you don't know the square root of 289, which is 17, that's one thing. But ignorance of the Father's law is no excuse, and we will be held accountable for not knowing it. Even man's law will persecute you in your ignorance of it. They will lock you up and say, see you in 25 years. Well, you didn't know that was illegal. Now you know. So we have to do our due diligence to be up on all the things that we should know. We can never claim ignorance, especially as wise adults, or the wise adults we should be. Now, question time for my Sunday worshipers out there. Why do you worship on Sunday? Huh? Now, I know for many of you, it's simply just that it's all you've ever known. That's what you were taught. That's how you were raised and all those type of things. And that was the same for me. But somewhere along the line, when I was around 40-ish, I learned some things that changed my mind, that put me on a different path. The only thing I ever knew about worshiping on any other day growing up was that there were some that worshiped on Saturday, but they were considered strange, odd, fanatics, etc., what have you. I never knew that they were keeping the Sabbath. I spent most of my life just partially informed about what people were doing on Saturday. Come to find out that it is the Sabbath according to the word. If we're raised a certain way and we just do a certain thing for so long, we become stubborn and resistant to change. But sometimes we need to change for the better. So what I'm going to do is inform some of you with some new information and some new knowledge, and you can do with it what you will. We still have that free will. I'm going to go out on a limb and just presume that most Sabbath keepers know and understand why they worship on Saturday or the seventh day or the Sabbath. Let me say it this way. As a Sabbath keeper, you have to know why you're keeping the Sabbath. It's part of the wisdom, part of the knowledge, part of the education. But you also have to understand and know why people keep Sunday, so you can know why you're doing something different from the majority. So most Sabbath keepers understand and know why they keep the Sabbath. So what we're going to do right now is get informed about Sunday and the Sabbath for those of you who don't know or don't know as much as you want to know or should know. So first, let's educate ourselves on Sunday. Now, keep up, because I'm going to go kind of quick, and I'm really just skimming some of the surfaces to give you a groundwork for understanding. And I just want you to get a good understanding, because if you're truly concerned or interested, you will dig and search, and you will go out there into the World Wide Web and pull up most of the information yourself. First, know that man named all the days of the week after his deities, things, and people that they wanted to hold reverence to and worship, like the sun for Sunday, Thor for Thursday, Saturn for Saturday, Tammuz Fatuzi, etc. There are many more deities, planets, stars, whatever, that plenty of them named the days of the week after. The Father numbered them as to not have us give respect of any day over another, except for the one He chose. Sunday worship was not intended to be the day of worship by the Almighty Father Yahweh. He told us at creation in Genesis 2:3 and in Exodus 20:11, He reaffirmed this with the children of Israel, what His sanctified day is and was. And that hasn't changed, no matter how much rumor, conjecture, false information, what have you, is out there, because He changes not. Malachi 3:6 tells us that He changes not. But first, go with me to Genesis 2:3. Genesis 2:3 reads, "So God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it He had rested from all His work which God created and made." In other words, He divinely and supremely favored and appointed it to be kept holy or set apart from all the other days, so that man might therein consider the excellency of His works and Yahweh's goodness toward him. In Exodus 20:11, He reaffirms what He established at creation now to the children of Israel, since they had just come out of bondage for hundreds of years. So they really didn't know or remember or understand. You're talking generations that passed. So He reaffirmed this in Exodus 20:11 to the children of Israel after the Exodus at Mount Sinai. But then man came along with his little hands in there dibbling and dabbling and changed the seventh day of the week to the first day of the week, a day that was not sanctified by the Father, a regular, normal day. So keep up. These are 10 quick things that you need to understand. Number one, the days of the week are numbered 1 through 7 by the Almighty Himself. Two, Sunday or the first day of the week has no biblical foundation whatsoever to be the day of worship. There's nothing in scripture that says so. Number three, Emperor Constantine enacted what is considered to be the first Sunday law, making Sunday the official day of worship. Number four, this edict by Emperor Constantine was added to an already established sun cult in existence, which was established by Emperor Aurelian in 274 AD. Number five, Constantine also served under Pontifex Maximus, who was a pagan, and the edict or law that was passed by Constantine only added to and solidified the day of sun worship, which already existed, as I just said. Also, number six, Pontifex Maximus is by whom we get the title of pontiff. That's where that title comes from, or the name Pope. So we know that Pope comes from the pagan roots of Pontifex Maximus. Number seven, the church, the Roman Catholic Church, not the people, the Roman Catholic Church made a sacred day out of Sunday, sun worship. This is something that they do not deny. This was part of the weekly festival of celebration to the sun or sun worship. Number eight, it was also Christian policy at that time to take over all pagan festivals endeared to the people by tradition and give them a Christian significance. This is how many of them were blended together. And it's still going on. The Christian churches, they're dragging all these different worldly things into the church. And they're not supposed to be doing that. Number nine, Pope Sylvester, 314 to 335 AD, he instructed his clergy at that time to keep the feria or the Roman festival days. And that comes from an old custom that he called the first day or the Lord's Day, on which the light was made in the beginning and also the resurrection of Christ is celebrated. So remember, when you hear the term Lord's Day, it's in reference to Sunday or the first day of the week. And this comes from Pope Sylvester, who named the first day such. Number 10, this is the Pope who also was first among the Romans who ordered that the names of the days of the week be called according to the names of their own gods. And there are plenty of them, like I said, plenty of gods, deities, things, planets, stars, what have you. So understand, people, that the Roman Catholic Church does not deny that they changed the Sabbath, the seventh day, to the Lord's Day, the first day of the week. And they're clear that the Sabbath is the seventh day and the Lord's Day is the first day. So there's no confusion there. But keep in mind also that this is about power and leadership, not about the people. People are just people. The ruling bodies are what creates and make and enforce all these changes. Also notice that now some people say, well, any day can be a Sabbath And technically, they are correct. They are 100% correct. Any day can be a festival day, a feast day, or a day of worship. But don't get that confused with the Sabbath day, the sanctified day that the Father chose, the seventh day. Don't get that confused with any other day. Also, know this, the Roman Catholic Church and or the papacy was and still is the most powerful and richest entity with influence politically and spiritually in this world today. Its power is still constantly growing. And as it did before, it will soon convince world governments to enact Sunday laws again for these current generations. And if you look in some of the news headlines over the past couple years, you see it is already doing so. But my question is, why would you have to have laws to mandate that Sunday is the official and legal day of worship? Hold that thought, because it's very important that you understand why. Why should it matter what day someone worships on? So apparently there's a point to this. Now, in the Converse Catechism of Catholic Doctrine, here are four questions that the church was asked, and here are their answers. They do not deny anything. The information is not secret, it's not hidden, it's out there. Most people don't know it because they don't read. Now, here it is. First question, what is the Sabbath day? Saturday is the Sabbath day. Number two, why do we observe Sunday instead of Saturday? We observe Sunday instead of Saturday because the Catholic Church transferred the solemnity from Saturday to Sunday. Why did the Catholic Church substitute Sunday for Saturday? The Church substituted Sunday for Saturday because Christ rose from the dead on a Sunday and the Holy Ghost descended upon the apostles on a Sunday. And because the Pope told them to way back when, because Constantine enacted an edict way back then, because they wanted to blend everything together way back then, because they didn't want Saturday to remain the day of worship. And number four, by what authority did the church substitute Sunday for Saturday? The church substituted Sunday for Saturday by the plenitude of the divine power which Jesus Christ bestowed upon her. And I say it as it's written, as Jesus Christ, because Yeshua did not bestow that power upon them. Now, this is just some of the information that explains some of the who, what, when, where, and how the Sabbath was changed from the seventh day of the week to the first day of the week. And Scripture confirms none of these changes as being done in the name of the Father's Word, because it isn't so. It's a false worship that's going to be solidified by law again. But again, I ask the question, why do you need a law if only a small few of us are keeping the Sabbath, the seventh day, as opposed to Sunday, the first day, which the majority keep anyway? See, they don't want anyone keeping the Sabbath. And really, this gets back to the enemy. Now, hold that thought. What I want y'all to do is pay attention to this clip by the extremely popular T.D. Jakes and listen to closely what he's saying in it. And I previously did a small video about this sermon that he did and pointed out some of these same things again, but I'm going to do it in a different way this time.
Now, I grew up in the Baptist church, and a very traditional Baptist church at that, and I grew up going to Sunday school and vacation Bible school. And when I went to vacation Bible school and Sunday school, they taught me about the Sabbath day. And there was a great debate going on at that time as to what day was the real day to worship God. That debate continues to this day and has existed all the way back to the Old Testament theology as to what is the right day to worship God. In spite of the fact that the New Testament tells us not to give respect of days, we're still debating over what day we ought to worship. I had run into some good friends as a young man that were Seventh-day Adventists, and I still have a lot of friends who worship the Lord on Saturday, which technically is the Sabbath day.
Now, in the unedited video, he said these things in order. He grew up Baptist, he went to Vacation Bible School, and they taught him about the Sabbath. There was also a debate, which is true today, about which day is a true day of worship. Now, isn't it interesting that he said that? Because he knows Genesis 2:3 and Exodus 20:11 says that the seventh day is a true day of worship. But he threw that in there anyway. See, it already throws people in a different direction when you do things like that. Number four, he said, in spite of the fact that the New Testament tells us not to give respect of days, we're still debating over which day we are to worship. Now, hold up. People have to listen carefully to what people like T.D. Jakes are saying because his influence affects people's lives. He says that in spite of the fact that the New Testament says to us not to give respect of days. Now, if we read the commandments, Genesis 2:3 and Exodus 20:11, the Father says, this day is a special day. He's telling us to give respect to a specific day. But Mr. Jakes comes along and says, the scripture says, not to give a respect of days, but we're going to touch on that one because that's where a lot of that confusion comes from. And then the last thing he says that's relevant, he says, Saturday is technically the Sabbath day. So he understands. See, technically it is or it isn't. When someone says, well, technically, see, it makes you take that fact lightly or not give it the credibility that it's due. But he said, in spite of the fact that the New Testament tells us not to give respect to days, what we're going to see about that. Go with me to Romans 14:5. Romans 14:5 reads, this man esteemeth one day above another day, and another man counteth every day alike. Let every man be fully persuaded in his mind. Now, let me correct Mr. Jakes and any of you that need understanding of this scripture before we go any farther. This scripture in no way implies or says that one day is any different than the other. And it's already clear that the Father says that one day is different than the rest of the days. This scripture is first giving an example of the difference of days according to the law. Now, the reference in the Geneva says this, he setteth against this contempt and hasty or rash judgments a continual desire to profit, that the strong may be certainly persuaded of their liberty, of what manner of sort it is, and how they ought to use it. And again, the weak may daily profit, lest either they abuse the gift of God, or these please themselves in their infirmity, that he may say in his conscience that he knoweth and is persuaded by Jesus Christ that nothing is unclean of itself, and this persuasion must be grounded upon the word of God. So let me explain what that means. That is simply saying that some will esteem one day above another for their convenience, because they may want to profit or use it for their gain, or they're going to convince themselves that it's not really saying what it's saying, all these different types of things for their own selfish benefit. That's simply and bottom line what it's saying. People esteem one day above another on their own accord, but we all have to be persuaded in our own mind what we're going to do with the information and the word he gives us. So now what I'm going to do is play that same video clip back, rearrange, because this is what Mr. Jakes is really saying. When you put the things he said in the order that they need to be in and remove all the fluff out of the way. And it's really interesting because all he's doing is confirming what the word says or denying what the word said. And hear what he is really saying once you unscramble the points.
In spite of the fact that Saturday, which is the Sabbath day, we're still debating over what day we ought to worship.
We decide to place one day above another of our own accord because of what we want to gain or profit from it, convincing ourselves that it's okay. And four, and yes, some of us are still debating over the true day of worship. For what reason, I do not know. The Father's word is clear. So to all my Sunday keepers out here, as I previously was in life, this is why you keep Sunday. This is the reason why Sunday is your day of worship. This is why it became your day of worship. And I did the same thing. So I don't judge anyone because of what they're doing. But one thing you're going to find out before it's all said and done, you're going to have to make a choice. And the day you choose to keep is going to be tied to all sorts of things. Persecution, salvation, or what have you. Some of you have no idea what's about to unfold, but I'm telling you, it's going to really start to take off once the Pope comes over in September. Pay attention, people. Laws and things are changing, and we're all going to have to make choices. And with that being said, this is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.